All right.
All right, here we go.
All right.
Q&A.
All right, all right.
All right, yeah, all right.
Sorry for the technical stuff last week, but we're back this week.
I know. I was going to say, that's true.
I mean, really just one question. You know, great job talking about. I mean, a big thing you hit today was the importance of community, having that intentional community around you.
Yeah.
And so one of the questions we got actually in between services was someone said, what if you've tried to take that step and you found it difficult for, you know, various, there are all kind of reasons why that can be difficult.
Yeah.
You hit some of them in your talk today, but whether they feel, you know, just something weird going on there, or they can't find the right community, or maybe the steps aren't even easy enough, which we're trying to make better. Because we realize that's a thing sometimes.
Yep.
Or sometimes maybe some people feel like there are cliques, those kind of things, and it's hard to break through those. How would you, if someone's having some of those issues, whatever they may be?
Well, let me talk to the introverts first.
Okay.
Because I know it's hardest. It's hardest for the introverts because, number one, stepping out and trying to be intentional about relationships is already hard.
Oh, yeah.
And so I would say keep trying and just continue to pray. Like, pray like crazy that God will help introduce the right people to you.
Yeah.
One of the ways in which you can do it here at Journey is, you know, our gathering for ladies and our B3 for men is an opportunity for you to go to a large group kind of setting and meet people.
Right.
And just connect. And we know some examples even in the gathering where people have met some other people, and it's been through that, because they're a little more introverted, it's been through that they've been able to create a relationship with somebody, and then that relationship helped them go to a group, you know, help them go to a group and actually then connect with more people, which was great. And so that was good. For men, it's a little bit harder. For extroverts, it's just keep trying.
Yeah.
You know, most extroverts don't struggle that much because they just think it's everybody else's fault and it's not theirs. So they just keep trying, keep trying, keep trying. But I would say that, you know, one of the biggest things is the enemy wants to tell you when it doesn't work.
Right.
The enemy wants to tell you that it's your fault, that you're the problem, and to not try. Mm-hmm. And you know what? There may be things in you that, you know, that you're not even aware of that can rub people wrong or do whatever. That's fine. Maybe the enemy wants to point those out.
Right.
But don't let that stop you. He has relationships for you in the body of Christ.
Yep.
You got to find them. You got to pray to find them. And when you find them, you need to be intentional about keeping.
Absolutely.
Keep leaning in, man.
Yeah.
Keep moving in that direction. It's not easy. And I'll just say that from the standpoint of us being in church forever.
Right.
Right. It's not easy. I can be just like anybody else and float to my few.
Yeah.
That it's easy to like and easy to converse with and easy to do. It's intentional even for me as the pastor to be in circles and in groups and with people that don't think like me, don't might not even like me. And you know, they definitely question me. It's intentional for me to make sure that I know and they know that they're just as much as a part of the body of Christ as I am.
Yeah.
And that my goal is to love them, serve them, encourage them, be unified in what we can be unified about. It's got to be intentional for me too. So it's not easy, no matter who you are. Just keep trying.
Well, intentional is the word, you know.
Intentional is
the
word.
You know, I'll speak personally. Even right now, we've had some life change transitions, and you know, we've got to get back on the intentional train. You know, of getting that, because we miss it and we value it, and so we haven't had that for probably 6 months or so.
In a
consistent manner.
Yeah,
and we still have times where we get together. You know,
right.
You know,
but life transitions do that. Life transitions can up. You know, when you're uprooted or stuff happens, It can mess with it. And it's not that it's not, there's not purpose in it or something that God's going to use in it. But at the same time, like you said, if you're not intentional about it, that can go from a 6 month or a year to 3 years.
Well, I think that's what I was trying to say is that's the thing is to be intentional.
Be intentional.
Take a step and just, you know, don't give up. You know,
don't give up.
You got to try and find
that's right. Awesome.
Find what you need. All right.
All right. Thanks.
See you guys.